I want to get a better look at that photographer that was on the ring apron during the Hulk Hogan loss to Yokozuna. Oh, what a clothesline there. This big, powerful athlete has just really impressed me, I can tell you that.
I want to take another look at Yokozuna kicking out from the Hulkster's leg drop, which no one has ever done. And then the Hulkster trying three times unsuccessfully to reach deep in the crotch and slam the big cup.
Yeah, that was a tremendous effort by Hulk Hogan, but it just shows you the awesomeness of Yokozuna. And we're seeing an awesome display right here with this young atom bomb kick right to the midsection. And we don't know a great deal about this young man, and even less about his erstwhile manager on the outside, Johnny Polo. We know Polo's a friend of the Brains, which doesn't speak too highly. Oh, man, for him. Man, he gutted him right across the top ring rope. This guy's a little sadistic, Gorilla.
He may be spending, this youngster may have to spend a few hours in the emergency ward.
Here's this big 300-pounder up on the top rope.
Look at that agility.
Oh. Elbow caught him right in the sternum.
Well, Polo says to polish him off, and that's exactly what this guy's doing.
Adam Baum has been most impressive in each and every outing that we have seen him in here in the WWF, and he calls that the Adam Smasher. He hooks the near leg, and that's only academic. Another victory for this young man.
Here is your winner, Adam.
And look at the eyes, Gorilla.
Let's go back if we can and take a look at some of the action went down earlier on in this one. This guy needs help.
He does.
Take a look here. Beautiful high vertical suplex. Oh. And then he just, instead of dropping him backwards, just hangs him up on the top rope. Wow.
And the Adam Smasher finishes him off. Mean Gene's got some big news for us. Let's go back to Gene and Bobby.
You got to tell me, Orker.
I have to tell you, squat.
Yes,
Ian.
You do. You have to tell me these things.
Hey, I was very impressed with Adam Baum. Not too impressed, however, with his manager, Johnny Polo.
Oh, Johnny Polo's a class guy. Just the other day, we're down in West Palm Beach, Florida. Took me to some of the finest restaurants. Gets a table like that. He's a class guy. He's a fun guy to run with.
I don't trust a guy that plays croquet from the back of a horse.
Not from that. That's Polo. Croquet's the thing where you get the ball and you... I don't know. Tell me what's going on, will you?
Well, Bobby Heenan, this week has been just incredible. I mean, back and forth, up and down. The long and the short of it is that Rick and Scott, the Steiner brothers, upended Money Incorporated, and they are the new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions.
From inside the pages of the WWF magazine, here's Update.
No, you almost got it. No, that was in Rockford. Well, just Kevin... Just keep quiet and listen and keep your pants on, and I'll explain it so that even you can understand. I gotta go. Goodbye. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Update. I'm Gorilla Monsoon, and the tag team situation here in the WWF is just unbelievable. See these two guys, Money Inc.? They're out. It all happened last Monday night is when it all began in Columbus, Ohio, when the Steiner brothers defeated Money Incorporated for the belts. But listen to this, folks. Money Incorporated, very smart upstairs where the gray matter is concerned. They had a return clause in their contract so that on Wednesday in Rockford, Illinois, under very suspicious circumstances, Money Incorporated got their tag team belts back. Then the saga continues. Three nights later in the Gateway City with a big arch, St. Louis, Missouri, Steiner Brothers did it again. They defeated Money Incorporated and became an unprecedented two-time in 1 week holder of the WWF tag team belts. Imagine that.
New tag team champs. It was a long, hard, tough road. We may have been overconfident once or twice, but we got the belts now, and we're going to keep them. We worked all our lives to be WWF Tag Team Champions. We're going to work that much harder to keep them for a long time.
Well, there you have it, folks. Signed, sealed, and delivered. It is a fact right now. Steiner Brothers are indeed the reigning WWF Tag Team Champions. But Rick and Scott, I got news for you. Guys, it's not going to be easy to hold on to those belts. I can see it right now. It's in the books. Return matches all over the lot, all over the United States, all over the world for that matter, against Money Incorporated. And folks, if you're lucky enough to have that particular match in your hometown, you could be part of history because it's been proven that when these two teams get together, something drastic always happens, and you could be part of and see a tag team title change hands right in your own hometown. Well, we'll keep you up to date on everything that goes on here in the WWF. So until next week, Gorilla Monsoon saying, so long, everybody.
I mean, this is like the stock market crashing.
Well, it's not quite that serious. Is,
no.
Just a second, folks. Stay tuned when we return.
We're
going to be back with Mr. Perfect.
Face.
One
He's
of my favorites.
Hey, like I ate a skunk.
I'm trying to talk here. Will
you
give me a
break?
If you want to save money, you'll have to be snappy. With a sale this big, you got to be happy.
I have to tell you, your song is really crap.
Just me, Billy. Just me, eh?
30% off our best all-season radials. Sale ends soon.
This great Canadian cabin party begins with a journey to the mountains, accompanied by the right group of friends and the proper gear.
We're traveling light this time.
At an intimate setting in the great outdoors.
Oh, wow, what a great place for a party.
Where you can listen to the call of the wild. Molson Canadian rocks what the great Canadian summer is all about.
If you want to save money, you'll have to be snappy. With a sale this big, you gotta be happy.
I have to tell you, your song is really crap.
Just me, Billy, just me, eh?
30% off our best all-season radials. Sale ends soon.
There's a lot of bad breath out there.
And it's my duty to try to do something about it.
Hey, do you know what you're eating there?
Fish? No, garlic. Your breath. You ever heard of Clorets?
You! I don't want you on my roof anymore.
Check. Here, try these.
Get tough with your breath. Get Clorets!
Alpine, JVC, Mitsubishi, Sharp, Gold Star, Canon, they all said yes. 25 major manufacturers said yes to the Factory Direct Super Sale. Brand name electronics at Factory Direct prices. Corner of Brandon, Fairview Street, Burlington. Digital car stereos, $48. CD player, $67. Car speakers, $8 a pair. Microwave ovens, $88. TVs, VCRs, car stereos, video cameras, up to 86% off. The Factory Direct Super Sale, Thursday at noon till Sunday at 6. Corner of Brandon, Fairview Street, Burlington. Sponsored by Bass Electronics.
For your information, the superstars of the WWF present fantastic action close to you. Sunday, July 11th, Toronto, Ontario. Saturday, July 10th, Montreal, Quebec. Friday, July 9th, Calgary, Alberta. Thursday, July 8th, Edmonton, Alberta.
Congratulations. Got to go out to Rick and Scott Steiner, the new WWF Tag Team Champions.
St. Louis, Missouri will go down in the record book because that's where the history was made as the Steiner brothers took the belts once again back from Money Incorporated. Wow, I can't keep up with this, Jim Ross.
And this goes to show you that on any given night, wherever you see WWF action, anything can happen. And we're ready to go here, Mr. Perfect, to take on P.J. Walker. And it's a collar and elbow tie up, and Perfect, what a matchup, Gorilla, he had with...
The King of the Ring.
Oh.
What a classic confrontation between he and the Hitman. That match alone worth the price of the pay-per-view.
You're exactly right.
No
question. One of the finest matches I've ever seen.
Or ever will.
You're right. You're right. Great effort by both men. Side headlock by Mr. Perfect, who has the perfect combination of size and speed and great expertise. Nice shoulder block by Mr. Perfect. Shows great agility. Going up and over. Walker caught him with a drop kick. Tremendous athletic gifts possessed by this young man in a knife edge, and you can hear that, and Walker out of desperation raking at the face of Mr. Perfect. I think got him in the eye.
Nice haircut too on Walker. Excuse me.
Looks like he just got a court martial or something out of the military as Perfect caught him again with those knife edge shots. Two-time Intercontinental Champion would like to be the first man in WWF history to make it three. Snaps the neck there.
That belt, of course, back around the waist of one Shawn Michaels.
And he is even more imposing now that he's got that big bodyguard, almost 7 feet tall. They call him Diesel.
Diesel indeed. High-powered, high-performance Diesel. Take a look at this second-generation expertise. He can do it all.
He certainly can. Has no flaws. Indeed, he certainly lives up to his name of Mr. Perfect as he's caving in the ribs of P.J. Walker.
You know, but to get in there and take a shellacking like this from a guy like Mr. Perfect only adds to your own ability, only adds to your own repertoire of what to do and what not to do inside that squared circle.
Boy, that's a devastating maneuver right there. I don't see anybody else but him using that. Driving that knee down. And this is the one that he has, excuse the pun, perfected. It's the perfect flex. He's got the hands up. It is over, Gorilla. I think the fork is ready.
Stick it in him. He's done.
Mr. Perfect. He'll be wearing the gold again someday. You got to believe it.
Here we go back in time. If we can quickly take a look once again at Mr. Perfect in action. Here's what Jim Ross likes.
Oh, wow.
Right on those lateral collateral ligaments. And then the coup de grace right there.
Indeed, ladies and gentlemen, he's perfect.
Welcome, fans. 2 weeks from this Sunday night, that is Sunday night, July 11th, we have an exciting WWF card for you right here at the Maple Leaf Gardens. And by the way, tickets are available at the box office and all Ticketmaster outlets. This promises to be a grueling matchup. Hacksaw Jim Duggan has the opportunity to become WWF champion when he faces reigning champion, the 550-pound Yokozuna. Singles competition, El Matador Tito Santana will grapple with the mysterious Papa Shango. Then the very dangerous Razor Ramon will face my guest standing by right now. He is the pride of the Lumbee Nation, Tatanka. Tatanka, you will be facing a man that gets very upset when he hears 1, 2, 3.
Seems Razor Ramon has heard 1, 2, 3 a lot lately in the World Wrestling Federation. Well, Razor Ramon, in about 2 weeks, we will meet on the battlefield at the Maple Leaf Gardens in Toronto. You'll walk around the World Wrestling Federation, no respect for others, wearing all the gold around your neck, having the easy way of life. Well, Razor Ramon, my people know how it feels to have the hard way of life, how to climb from the bottom and go to the top. And I know there's few, a lot out there, that feel the same way. Well, Razor Ramon, at the Maple Leaf Gardens, not only will I make you respect me and all my people, you will respect this Native American and one more time, you will hear 1, 2, 3.
Yeah! Thank you very much, Tatanka, the undefeated Native American. The fans love you here in Toronto, and I am sure the Maple Leaf Gardens will be sold out just for you. And now, in the matchup, tag team action matchup, the titles will be on the line. Joining me right now, face-to-face, former champions, Money Incorporated, and the new WWF champions, the Steiner Brothers. Money Incorporated, will you please stop whining about the fact that you lost the titles? You will have the chance to get them back right here at the Maple Leaf Gardens.
You're saying that we're whining? Let me tell you something, Ray. You got a smirk on your face. You're smiling. I think you're really enjoying this. But I don't really care, because we're going to wipe the smirk off your face, and we're going to wipe the big grin off the face of the Steiner Brothers, who are going to end up the shortest reigning tag team champions in World Wrestling Federation history. And you can take that to the bank.
You know, Steiner Brothers, Money Incorporated, have been claiming that you robbed the titles from them. Is that true?
You know, Ray, they sound like just a couple of crybabies. But they found out, just like every tag team in the WWF is finding out, that nobody gets up from the Frankensteiner. You know, they're a great team, and that's a fact that was never in doubt. But their ways of winning were always suspect. Their buyouts, their payoffs, and the rip-offs were something we had to deal with them. We dealt with them, and now we're the new tag team
champions. Hey, Steiner, I've got a little advice for you and your brother. Get to the Maple Leaf Gardens early and show the belts off, because we're leaving with them.
You know how you always say you wished I had more friends?
Hello, Mrs. Madigan.
For anyone who's ever looked for adventure.
I hate when that happens.
Wanted a girl.
What a cutie.
And needed a friend.
Jack!
This hero stuff has its limits.
Columbia Pictures presents...
Come on!
An adventure for the kid inside us all.
Yes!
Arnold Schwarzenegger, Last Action Hero. At theaters now.
different beers there are these days. Lights, drafts, cold filtereds, dries. Trends. Yeah, people try them, and they usually come back. Yeah, they come back.
There's a lot to be said for a distinctive, full-flavored beer, and there's one Molson Ale that says it all.
Hold it! Where's everybody gone? Why, obviously, they've heard about Pizza Hut's incredible $5 deal. Buy one regular price medium pan pizza and get up to four more for...
$5!
Yes, the word is out. Get one medium for regular price, and the next four are each...
$5!
No wonder everyone's headed for...
Pizza Hut and nothing but.
Watch Blue Jays Baseball on the BBS Sports Network for your chance to tune in to win great prizes. You could be the winner of a grand prize, Joe Carter's 1993 official Blue Jays Accord from Honda, one of three runner-up prizes, or one of over 1,000 bonus prizes. Play, tune in to win every time the Blue Jays play on the BBS Sports Network. To play, pick up your baseball playbook at participating Shell stations and Subway sandwich shops throughout Ontario.
Yokozuna, 550 pounds. Brother, you're bigger than ever. You've issued a challenge to any American professional athlete to try to body slam you. Not only on the 4th of July, but worst of all, on the USS Intrepid. Brother, look no further. Take a good, long look at your destiny.
What are you shaking your head for, Brain? What am I, throwing a curve at you?
I'm gonna like to shake my head. It's my head. Every time I think of Bret the Hitman Hart winning the King of the Ring, and then the way he was laid out by Jerry, the real King Law,
that was
does my heart good. But thinking of the Steiner brothers wearing the gold, they'll probably pawn it and get themselves comic books or something. They're nuts, you know.
You know, Bobby Heenan, this beautiful lake here in the background reminds me of that little lake spot I got up at Big Sandy Lake up there in northern Minnesota. Beautiful, isn't it?
Doesn't look anything like Minnesota. Minnesota stinks. It's cold, full of mosquitoes, and the people are illiterate. Go ahead.
What do you work for, the State Chamber of Commerce?
No, I have nothing to do with Minnesota.
Okay, very good. Hey, Bobby Heenan, once again, Yokozuna, the big fan from Japan, well in excess of 500 pounds. Once again, is the new World Wrestling Federation champion. And, of course, we all know about that exciting challenge that he has issued.
Well, being World Wrestling Federation champion, he can just about do what he wants to do. And when he starts issuing challenge...
All right, we're going to be talking about that, by the way, between now and the 4th of July. Let's get to action. Gorilla Monsoon and Jim Ross are standing by to call this one between the great Bob Backlund and Doink the Clown. Hey, don't pollute the lake.
No, it's a rock.
And what a blockbuster it's going to be on the 4th of July on the decks of the USS Intrepid, the Stars and Stripes Challenge. Yokozuna challenging every professional athlete in the U.S. of A. How about that?
I tell you, the calls are coming in, not only athletes from the WWF, but the National Football League, the NBA, Major League Baseball, the National Hockey League, pro boxing. Everybody's inquiring about this body slam, this body slam challenge, the Stars and Stripes challenge. It's going to be something. The thing about it, Gorilla, as Doink gets in the ring, Yokozuna has never been slammed.
Well, there's always the first time, isn't
it? You better believe it. And I think somebody's going to do it on the 4th of July.
Well, I think if Charles Barkley had to hurt his elbow and took that horrendous fall on the floor, on the hardwood there, he might just try it.
Well, that's a very good point. I know Charlie's pretty competitive. Bob Backlund, another competitive individual. Bob Backlund, former WWF champion.
And a great one at that.
He's the WWF's answer to Nolan Ryan.
He certainly is. Just keeps on going.
Always in great condition. You know one thing, Gorilla, about Doink the Clown? I'm not a big fan of his ring attire, but I am a fan of his wrestling ability. This guy is a darn good wrestler.
Well, he's shown us week after week that he possesses fine tools inside. He brings a lot to the table, no denying that. But like you, Jim, I question his attire.
Yeah.
I question his motives.
Right.
And I question his psychiatric state of mind.
Well, you wonder what he's trying to hide with this that, all that paint on his face and this this green hair piece. Nice takedown by Bob Backlund. You wonder about this guy's background, but in any event, the point I wanted to make is that he does have great wrestling skills, but that face really tells a story. This guy's got problems.
He certainly does.
He loves to make people unhappy. Backlund, quick go behind. Nice waist lock, but it was blocked there, and a drop toe hold by Doink the Clown.
Backlund used that switch move to come right out in front, and now they look eye to eye.
This could certainly be an interesting confrontation as it progresses here. And another drop toe from the Hammerlock. Good combination wrestling move. Almost scored this one on points, Gorilla.
Yeah, got that cross body right in there, but Backlund right up to his feet and sticks that leg between the crotch. Oh, look at this.
Nice move by Backlund, taking Doink the Clown down. And look how quickly Backlund regains his vertical base. Always ready to compete, and you rarely ever see Backlund turn his back on his opponent.
Absolutely not. You're in a land of no return if you do that. Oh, nice block of the hip lock attempt, and delivered one of his own.
Oh, Backlund's got a lot of strength. His strength is a little bit deceiving. He's not a 300-pounder, but he's got great strength, keeps himself in magnificent cardiovascular conditioning, and he really has mastered the art of leverage. That's so important.
Doink wanted to regroup there. Of course, then you got to be thinking about how many Doinks there are in the building or under the ring or waiting in the parking lot or who knows.
Well, we've already seen one clown on this program. He's with Okerlund. That's the brain.
The blonde-haired one with the red jacket, right?
Yeah.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, nice counter move into the overhand wrist lock by Backlund. And Doink took that shortcut, pulled the hair, but didn't have the advantage for long. And the referee chastising Backlund. I don't know what for. Always been. I think that there was an allegation made that Mr. Backlund pulled the hair. And that's not true.
By the Doinkster, I'm sure. Boy, he'll take every edge that he can get, no question. Clean break, highly unlikely.
Exactly right. Those left forearms got in there, and Backlund fires back with a forearm of his own. Front face locking Doink, and maybe setting him up, yes, for a suplex here. Vertical suplex.
Oh, well executed.
Nicely done there, and Doink too close to the ropes. Pinning combination, good move by Backlund, but Doink was very, very close to the ropes and able to get his foot under the bottom rope.
Backlund realizing it's not any time to be clowning around now. Put this guy away if you can. A lot of guys have tried, I might add, unsuccessfully.
Well, Backlund's a great guy, believes deep in his heart in good sportsmanship. But Bobby, I don't think you can trust this guy. Back heel trip and the single leg and then the waist lock. Good move there. Great wrestling move by Doink, but he gains the advantage with a little bit of
got a little high
suffering.
There, lost it.
Backlund gains the advantage. Oh, look at Backlund ride Doink. See some excellent mat wrestling in this contest. And a headbutt. Lower abdomen there.
Extremely low.
And Doink trying to get Backlund up. Pile driver could be coming up, but Backlund counters. Back body drop by Bob Backlund. And Backlund front face lock.
Oh, small package.
Doink's got him, and he held him. Doink beats Backlund with an inside cradle.
Doink the Clown.
Well, Doink the Clown showed us some outstanding mat wrestling, Gorilla. And used that inside cradle, the small package, to defeat the former WWF champion.
Not too many guys can look at a record books and see their name alongside Bob Backlund's saying and declaring that they were the winner. Doink's really got something on the ball.
Very few people have ever out-wrestled Bob Backlund. And I can say right here that Doink used a very sound wrestling maneuver to secure the victory. And Backlund, that shows great sportsmanship right here. He's a class guy all the way. It's like you heard him say right there, he got beat fair and square.
Right in the middle of the ring. Referee right in the right position, too, to make the count. Well, you going to shake hands or not? I don't think so.
Well, I admire Bob Backlund.
He's got something in his hand now. Watch him.
Something in his hand. And the old cliche, something up his sleeve, certainly is applicable here to this man.
Keep your eye on him, Bob. Don't trust him.
Yep. I don't think he's going to shake your hand. Can never trust this guy.
Oh, look at that.
He's squirting Backlund in the face with something, and Backlund screaming. He squirted Bob Backlund in the eyes, and Backlund has been blinded here. But, oh, he nailed Doyle. I don't think he can even see him. He's swinging wildly.
That was just a lucky shot. Bob Backlund cannot see at this particular point in time. That was just a lucky blow by the former champion. What was that?
I don't know, but Backlund needs some medical attention. Backlund squirted right in the face, and here comes some officials to the ring. They've got to get those eyes washed out. This is a tough situation for Bob Backlund. Fans, we'll be back. Don't go away. We're back in a moment.
Abandoned, looking for food and shelter. Sometimes the innocent victims of abuse and neglect, but they don't have to be alone. With your help, the Toronto Humane Society can be there. We need you now so that we can rescue hundreds of unwanted or injured animals like Joey and Zorro. We'll provide them with temporary shelter, give them the medical care they need, and work to find them new homes. But we can only do it with your help. We receive no government funding, so please, call right now. We'll tell you more about the animals in our shelter and send you a photo of one of them. For as little as 63 cents a day, you can give an animal a new start in life. Say you care with a call.
TV proudly presents the Easy Money Contest at Woodbine Racetrack, starting this Sunday until July 31st. This contest is free, with thousands of dollars in cash prizes up for grabs. Plus, you could win a sensational 1993 convertible Suzuki Sidekick. The Easy Money Contest, starting this Saturday until July 31st at Woodbine Racetrack. It's where the money is.
And let's take you back now to last Monday night. Razor Ramon brought $10,000 with him. That was what it took to get the 1-2-3 kid back in the ring. $10,000. The kid wants to do it for his family. Is he risking life and limb here on Monday Night Raw?
Let me check on the phone here. Yes, Poughkeepsie General. I'd like to reserve a room.
Wait, look at this. Look at this. The kid going up in the top rope. The kid flies off. Gets him up there. Ramon, come
here. Well, he's a lucky kid.
And what a a cover. One, two, yeah.
No.
Razor, Ramon.
Come on, Razor.
What's going on? Look at this. Another kick in the solar plexus. One, two, three. Kid trying to set up Razor, Ramon. Reversal coming off the rope. Razor missing from the backside now. And the kid has gained confidence in these some 6 weeks. No question of that.
I'll tell you, I was surprised. I thought he'd step in the ring and then start begging and pleading. He took it to Razor. Won't do him any good, though.
Just how do you know?
Because he's going to make Razor mad. And when he makes Razor mad, Razor's going to stuff him in the bag.
Three times he almost pinned him.
Oh, my God. Oh. You talk about one of the premier competitors in the WWF. It is Razor, Ramon. There's no question about it. You have to give him that.
Not only that, but he's vicious right now because his reputation is out on the line.
Razor Ramon with a 1-2-3 kick. And yes, wait a minute. A nice maneuver. What's going on?
Oh, he broke his neck.
You know what?
He broke his neck.
You know what? I'm just hoping he's not hurt.
He's hurt.
Bad.
Is he moving?
His legs aren't moving. That's what I don't like to see.
$10,000 is not worth it. $1 million.
He's got covered him right there. Razor could have covered the kid right there.
Well, you think he wants to beat him? Pin him? He wants to make this punk kid suffer. And he's going to do it.
Look at the size of Razor Ramon.
What a shame. This is a shame right here.
Shame? That punk 1-2-3 kid went all over the world bragging about beating Razor Ramon. Now you got to pay for it,
he
kid.
Wasn't bragging.
Of course he was bragging.
He was not. He was talking about, indeed, it was an upset. He admitted himself.
No, he told everybody how he paintbrushed him and how he...
Look at this. Razor Ramon attempting to humiliate the kid. Look at this. $10,000. Riding on the matchup, the kid collecting $10,000 for stepping into the ring with Razor Ramon. But boy, is Razor ever taking that $10,000 out.
He's getting his money's worth.
He'll get $50,000 before he's done.
Oh, what a power slam.
I can smell it, and I can see it. He is oozing machismo right now.
That's it, Razor Ramon. Oozing with machismo as well as confidence. And the kid to the outside. Wait a minute, what's he doing?
He's going to get $50,000 worth out of his hide. That's what he's going to do.
Oh, no, wait a minute.
On the cement.
Oh. No, no, don't.
I know what he's going to do.
What?
The razor's edge on the cement.
Oh, no.
Oh, yeah.
Razor Ramon now with the 1-2-3 kid setting him up. Razor Ramon sets up the kid. This should not happen to anybody.
Don't do it.
It shouldn't happen. Oh, wait a minute.
Oh.
What a maneuver.
Mission impossible. Unbelievable.
Razor, get up and get him.
The kid going up to the top rope and... Oh, no. Gallant effort on the part of the kid.
Oh, gallant effort. Hey, yes. Poughkeepsie General, get that hospital bed ready. I'm going to send you one kid over.
A gallant effort on the part of the 1-2-3 kid. Unfortunately, Razor Ramon, just too much machismo. Nonetheless, give this young man credit for getting back into the ring.
He don't need credit. He's got 10 grand.
Oh.
I give him credit.
But look at Razor Ramon. You think he'd be satisfied with
no.
a win? No. Look what he's doing to this poor young man. Oh, no.
Well, the kid going up to the top again. This is what happened the last time.
Oh, no. 1-2-3. Got him.
Oh, no.
He didn't get him, but man, he's trying. Give him credit.
The kid, wait a minute. The kid has the money. The kid grabbed the money. Thief. He's a thief.
Get out of there.
The kid has the money. He's had enough of the match. Here comes Razor.
He's not running fast enough.
Wait a minute. Stay with it. Let's get it.
Keep going. The kid's going. He's going out of the arena.
On the street.
The kid just went out of the arena. Wait a minute. He's going to the... Hey, wait a minute.
He set Ramon up.
Awesome.
He's got $10,000.
The Ministry of Fast Food now declares three new food groups for under a dollar. And they're all at Taco Bell. Check them out. 69 cents, 89 cents, 99 cents. Now get your Taco Bell favorites like tacos, nachos, burritos, and border fries for under a buck. And, well, free drink refills, too. Get the great taste of Taco Bell for 69, 89, and 99 cents. Oh, and by the way, guys, like there really isn't a Ministry of Fast Food.
As you weigh the difference between air conditioners, remember, a Lennox comes with a feature no other air conditioner can offer. A quality Lennox dealer.
Quality, reliability, and value.
At Detail Heating and Air Conditioning, those words are our guarantee of customer comfort and satisfaction.
For the finest in Lennox products and service, see Boonstra Heating and Air Conditioning.
Call my friends at Boonstra today.
Now win up to $3,000 or don't pay till January of 94.
This beer is simply unlike any beer you've
blah,
ever
blah,
tried.
Blah, 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 blah,
it's
blah.
Double brewed, triple filtered,
blah,
and
blah, 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 blah,
to give it a taste.
This
you
beer
ever.
Is changing the way you think blah, about blah, beer
blah,
forever.
Blah, blah, blah,
and maybe
blah, blah,
even
blah.
Longer than that.
Alpine, JBC, Mitsubishi, Sharp, Gold Star, Canon, they all said yes. 25 major manufacturers said yes to the Factory Direct Super Sale. Brand name electronics at Factory Direct prices. Corner of Brandon, Fairview Street, Burlington. Video cameras, $588. 50-watt car amps, $27. TVs from $149. CD players, $67. TVs, VCRs, car stereos, video cameras, up to 86% off. The Factory Direct Super Sale, Thursday at noon till Sunday at 6. Corner of Brandon, Fairview Street, Burlington. Sponsored by Base Electronics.
Today, Bam Bam is not only the biggest, not only the meanest, not only the strongest, but the best wrestler in the WWF today. But there's one thing, Bonnie, that all you people don't know. Is that I have another side of me. That's right. I have a heart. I'm a man. Every man in the world today has a heart. And in this heart, I have feelings. I have sensitivity.
You have sensitivity, Bam Bam Bigelow?
I said I had sensitivity. I have found love. I have found someone that makes me madly in love with. And I want to bring her out right now. I want to introduce my main squeeze, my love chick.
Wait just a second. That's Luna Bashaw. Give me Luna Tick.
Hey, I only call her the Tick. Come here, honey. That's my girl right there. That's my squeeze. Come here, sweetheart. Hey, watch your step. Hey! This woman has a body that any model would die for. She has the mind of Einstein. And the guts, and we got what it takes to get the job done. This is my love, Tick.
Luna Tick, obviously, let me
out. Don't you ever call me Luna Tick. And another thing, you are standing just a little close to my man.
I'd like to know a little bit about this relationship.
Just look. Look at this body. Take a good hard look. Arnold Schwarzenegger, eat your heart out! Look! Look at this skull! Look at this skull! Mel Gibson, get out of the way! This man, on fire! And this man, makes me hot!
Bam! Bam!
There's a lot of bad breath out there!
Right.
And it's my duty to try to do something about it. Hey, do you know what you're eating there?
Fish? No, garlic. Your breath.
You ever heard of Clorets?
You! I don't want you on my roof anymore.
Check. Here, try these.
Get tough with your breath. Get Clorets.
Eggshells, like teeth, must retain calcium to stay strong. To demonstrate how Crest's formula protects teeth, we treated half this egg with regular Crest, the other half without. The egg is exposed to a weak acid solution similar to that which causes cavities. Crest's side remains hard, having locked in the calcium. The other side is weak, having lost its calcium. The egg test shows it. Crest locks in calcium to help lock out cavities.
Introducing a little downy. Ultra downy. It's much smaller, and just one tiny capful gives you the fluffiest softness. Watch.
One, one. Two, two. Three, three. Four, four.
Case closed. Ultra downy. One tiny capful for the height of softness.
The superstars of the WWF present fantastic action close to you. Sunday, July 11th, Toronto, Ontario. Saturday, July 10th, Montreal, Quebec. Friday, July 9th, Calgary, Alberta. Thursday, July 8th, Edmonton, Alberta.
Well, let's get some sun.
We'll duck out the back door. In the meantime, let's get to action involving the head shrinkers.
What door?
You're going to love this place.
Well, let's do the ring.
Well, Jim Ross, revenge has always been a very strong motive here in the WWF, and Harvey Whippleman has brought that to the pinnacle. However, I don't think that we've heard the other shoe drop yet.
Well, I think you're exactly right, and the thing about it right now, Paul Bearer's on the shelf, and the Undertaker, somewhere down the road, got to face Mr. Hughes. That's going to be a great battle. Hey, let me tell you about another battle. That's going to be when the new WWF Tag Team Champions, the Steiner Brothers, finally hook it up with the head shrinkers. That was a matchup that we saw at WrestleMania 9.
Absolutely.
One of the most physical matches that I've seen in years.
It certainly was a classic confrontation at WrestleMania 9, but now even more incentive riding for these head shrinkers because the Steiners have the gold.
And I think that the tag team scene here in the WWF certainly is much like the one-on-one competition. Anything can happen on any given night, and with Alpha on the outside of the ring, that certainly gives those two young men, the head shrinkers, a very
big edge,
a great opportunity to win the WWF Tag Team Championship. Could be a short reign for the Steiner Brothers as far as the head shrinkers are concerned.
Well, it's already been a short reign, you know, in this week span. They won it, they lost it, they won it. You know, if you don't like who the champions are, just wait a few days.
What is competitive? Anything can happen in the World Wrestling Federation double team offense here.
Whoa.
By the head shrinkers, and they almost beheaded Ralph there. Ralphie boy almost lost his head.
You know what I'm thinking also, Jim Ross, if these head shrinkers should become the WWF Tag Team Champions, they just might disappear with the belts. They just might go back to wherever they came from, back to Samoa, and forget about it and live off their reputation.
Oh, man, I tell you something, they like to fight. And that's in their heritage. I think there's a gut wrench here into a slam. You know, I've always heard all my life that the Samoan people are as competitive and as physical as any group of people.
Well, they certainly are. They fight amongst themselves, too.
They certainly do. They are very, very intense. Headbutt. Well, these guys are walking weapons. There's no doubt about it. They are as bad as they come. And when you get two people that are over 300 pounds, that absolutely, they have no regard for their opponents. They have even, they have no regard for their own physical welfare. There's off on the outside.
Now, he's well over that 300-pound mark, too. But there's somebody who will be hovering right around that 600-pound mark on the 4th of July in the Stars and Stripes Challenge, and that's Yokozuna, WWF reigning champion. He's challenged every professional athlete here in these United States to perhaps, in his opinion, and Mr. Fuji's, come out and make a fool of themselves.
Well, they this body slam challenge. Hulk Hogan couldn't body slam Yokozuna. Can any other professional American athlete? As well, these Samoans going up top.
Ooh.
And this is no, both guys right off the top, both head shrinkers,
double jeopardy,
dive bombing this young man, and this is over.
Welcome back, fans. 2 weeks from tomorrow night, we have a WWF blockbuster card for you right here in Toronto at the Maple Leaf Gardens. This all happened Sunday night, July 11th. Tickets, by the way, are available at the box office and all Ticketmaster outlets. Two titles on the line. Monty Incorporated will have an opportunity to become tag team champions when they face reigning champions, the Steiner Brothers. Then Marty Jannetty will square off against Blake Beverly in singles competition. Then that evil clown Doink has been a thorn in everyone's side for quite some time, especially to my guest right now. He is the powerhouse from Kona, Hawaii, Crush. Crush, you will finally have the opportunity to face this clown. I know you've been wanting to get your hands on him. He is a very dangerous individual. Don't be fooled by his appearance.
You know, like you said, July the 11th, Sunday night, Toronto, home of the world champion Blue Jays and home of the crazy Toronto fans that I love to wrestle in front of more than anybody in the world, brother, because they like to get crazy just like me, brother Ray. And Doink, no more excuses, brother. It's coming down. It's coming down to Toronto and me and you. And we'll see, brother, exactly who has what it takes to remain in the World Wrestling Federation. Two Doinks, it doesn't matter. No more excuses. I got my back covered. Let's get it on, brother.
All right. Best of luck to you. There you have it from the Powerhouse Crush. Standing by right now, reigning WWF champion Yokozuna, accompanied by his manager, Mr. Fuji. Mr. Fuji, this is a golden opportunity for Hacksaw Jim Duggan. He could step out of the ring here in Toronto at the Maple Leaf Gardens, WWF champion.
Let me tell you, Monsieur, took by Yokozuna, bingo, to beat five-time former WWF champion Hulk Hogan in King of the Ring. Now you, Hacksaw, you want to come and get a piece of my Yokozuna? Come, because my Yokozuna loves Toronto. Why he loves Toronto? Look at this, 550 pounds. He loves pizza. Oh, he do love pizza.
Hey, Mr. Fuji, Mr. Fuji, I have a surprise for you. Standing by now, your opponent for this event, Hacksaw Jim Duggan, the challenger.
Hacksaw, how are you, boy son?
I'm looking right at you, Mr. Fuji. I'm looking right at that 505-pound Japanese man.
550, he's gained weight, Jim.
Yeah. Well, he looks like he's gained some weight after winning that title. And I'm not going to take nothing away from the immortal Hulk Hogan, the greatest wrestler in the world. But understand one thing. Hacksaw Jim Duggan, I never said I was a great wrestler. I said I was a great fighter. So, Yokozuna, when you get in the ring, it's not going to be no wrestling match. It's going to be a fight, and I'm coming for you. And I'm coming for that, Mr. Fuji. And I'm coming for the belt, tough guy.
Folks, have a good week. We'll see you back here next time around for Super Card. Well, what is that? Milk?
I'm not milk. You think I'm a big cat?
The Toronto Blue Jays are on the road this week, and BBS is right there with them. Watch the Jays take on the Milwaukee Brewers tomorrow afternoon at 2 and see them up against the Baltimore Orioles Wednesday night at 7:30. Labatt Blue Jays Baseball on BBS tomorrow and Wednesday on CFTO-TV.
Hold it! Where's everybody gone? Why, obviously, they heard about Pizza Hut's incredible $5 deal. Buy one regular priced medium pan pizza and get up to four more for
$5.
Yes, the word is out. Get one medium for regular price and the next four are each
$5.
No wonder everyone's headed for
nothing but Pizza Hut and nothing but.
Did you think I'd crumble? Did you think I'd lay down and die? Oh, no.
You can talk the copper talk.
Watch Blue Jays Baseball on the BBS Sports Network for your chance to tune in to win one of our fabulous grand prizes. You could win Joe Carter's 1993 official Blue Jays Accord from Honda, free gas for a year from Shell, one of two complete sets of tires from Yokohama, plus over 1,000 bonus prizes. To play, pick up your baseball playbook at participating Shell stations and Subway sandwich shops throughout Ontario.
Now, McCain brings you French fries, the next generation. McCain Golden Crisp. The natural taste of fresh Canada No. 1 potatoes, locked in with a delicate crispy coating. So when you crunch through that crispy coating, you'll taste the best fries that ever came out of an oven. McCain Golden Crisp. New cross cracks and spirals. McCain Golden Crisp. The next generation.
This is CFTO-TV in Toronto.
On today's program, we're going to look at an ancient form of angling, float fishing. Now, in the old days, they used all sorts of items to keep their baits floating, from balsa wood to pieces of animal bone. Of course, today, with the advent of high injection molds and the new high-tech plastics, we've got a whole new generation of floats. Excuse me, fish on!
The Fish in Canada Show, the ultimate angling experience, coast to coast. With your host, Angelo Viola.
Yes, we're in for some good fishing.
And Reno Viola. Brought to you in part by your GM Good Rent Service Plus dealer. Musco, there's nothing more repellent. Zebco Motor Guide, the choice of serious fishermen. Mariner Outboards, better in the long run. And Silver Thread to Polymer Fishing Line.
Come along to our cabin in the wild, 'cause we're in for some good fishing, Canada.